Okay, I don't know, maybe I will disappoint you, but maybe not.
I'm beyond that.
Okay. So this is the title of my talk. I can't. No? Okay, I will try. So, this is the title of my talk. I am Gitman Bagrov, also is present on the conference, so everyone can see both authors. First of all, I would like to thank organizers for possibility to come to Israel and to present on this conference, which is important for me. Now, starting the subject, I remember that everybody knows that a charged particle moving in magnetic field always irradiates electromagnetic waves. From the quantum point of view, these are transitions between Landau levels with emissions of photons. If a particle is non-relativistic, this is cyclotron, so-called cyclotron radiation. And if a particle is relativistic, this is synchrotron radiation. Now, the question is, what will be if we place Aronov bomb solenoid along the direction of the magnetic field? How this radiation will be modified? And if Aronov bomb solenoid modifies this radiation, that will be Aronov bomb effect in particle radiation in magnetic field. At the same time, this can be interpreted as Aronov bomb effect for bound states, because states of electron in magnetic field is bound state. Not so. To answer this question, one has to study quantum motion of a charged particle in the so-called magnetic solenoid field, which is a combination between magnetic field and field of Aronov bomb solenoid. So here I put it description of magnetic solenoid field. It is combination of constant magnetic field, Aronov bomb field. Now, magnetic flux I am going to measure in terms of Dirac quanta and separate integer part of this flux. It is usual. And the difference between the flux and its integer part we call mantissa of the magnetic flux. This quantity is very important because all the effect depends only on mu. Only on mu. So here I put it potentials of the field which we studied, and results which were obtained studying in this field, one can divide in two parts. First, strict formal results about wave functions of an electron in such a field. Also, complete description of all self-adjoint extension of the corresponding operators with this field, and applications of this formal result to particle radiation in such a field. I don't know, here one has to have some information. Okay, here of course I will mention only the second part of these results. So let us start with with classical theory. Here we have solenoid, Aronov bomb solenoid, magnetic field. In classical theory, the particle doesn't feel solenoid. However, However, the presence of the solenoid has a topological effect. All the trajectories are divided in two classes. Those which embrace solenoid, red ones, and those which do not. Now, this we divide in two kinds of trajectories, zero trajectories and the kind one. Calculating the angular momentum projection, one can see that for red trajectories, angular momentum is always positive in quantum theory. Here in classical theory can be small negative. And for blue trajectories is always negative. It is important because we will use correspondence between quantum states and this classical image. So in classical theory we will find the same quantum numbers which are negative, and we will divide trajectories, quantum trajectories, in two types, which embrace and don't embrace solenoids. So, speaking about quantum problem, we have here commuting operator, Hamiltonian, angular momentum, its projection, momentum along that axis, and in spinning case, in Dirac equation case, we have spin, some spin operators. Of course, explicit form of the wave function is not possible to discuss here, but we have here quantum numbers, m, pz, l, l small. N, it marks energy levels, pz, momentum along z, l, angular momentum. If we select l like this, then there is complete correspondence between quantum states and classical picture which was shown before. So we have two types of states, state 0 and state 1. State 0 correspond to particle which don't embrace solenoid, and they coincide with states in pure magnetic field. And states 1, they are modified. All modifications are due mu, that mantis of magnetic flux. If mantis of magnetic flux is 0, no impact of Aronoff-Bohm solenoid on the spectrum, on the wave function. Here you can see the spectrum. In this part, you see the spectrum in pure magnetic field at the same time at mu equals 0. Here, mu is now 0, and we have splitting of Landau levels. So degeneracy in L, which we have in magnetic field, is lifted partially, so appears new levels, and we have explicit formula for energy. Here we can see wave functions, and of course these details difficult to pass now. But what is important, that radial motion is described by Laguerre polynomials. And as to asymptotics, as to the behavior on the solenoid line, which could be maybe unusual for people who work with Aronoff-Bohm effect, for these states, we have in wave function which goes to infinity, but square integrable. This is so-called strong, super strong spin solenoid interaction. So electron is real electron, feels the Aronoff-Bohm field. Now, using this wave function, we can calculate this Feynman diagram, and this is usual way to get radiation, one photon radiation. We have calculated this. This is not simple task, because in fact we have to repeat all calculation to get synchrotron radiation, and that took for people many, many years. So conclusions. Only if mu is not zero, we have difference between usual radiation in magnetic field and presence of the solenoid. Now, what is important also, that in pure magnetic field, intensity doesn't depend on initial L. Solenoid lifts completely this degeneracy. Now, here we have formulas for frequencies. So, because there is a splitting of levels, of course, frequencies are different. And we have exact formula for frequencies. Here you have pure magnetic field, usual frequencies, and here there appear new frequencies. What is more important, that could appear super low frequencies, and they are related to transition between the same energy, now the same, between energy levels with the same N. So, let me... This frequency can be evaluated, and these super low frequencies in non-relativistic, for example, limit, they are proportional, of course, to cyclotron frequency. One of super low frequency is mu omega zero, another one minus mu omega zero. And here more light material. Here we can see cyclotron radiation diagram. Blue is intensity in the absence of the solenoid. This is well-known intensity, and the maximum of irradiation is along the magnetic field. What is important also, that cyclotron radiation, in cyclotron radiation in this direction, only one harmonic is emitted always. So effectively we have transition between level N and N minus 1. But the presence of the solenoid, which is given by red, but changes the picture. First of all, we can have emission of many harmonics. You can see this. And we can have in this direction emission of super low harmonics. Now one can ask, of course, intensity of emission of super low harmonic is very small. Not very small, smaller than emission of harmonics due to magnetic field. But circular polarization of this super low harmonics is opposite to all other harmonics which are emitted here. So if we speak about possible experimental discovery of the effect, this can help, because super low harmonics are coming with opposite polarization in comparison with all other harmonics. Now, this is impact of Aronoff-Bohm solenoid on cyclotron radiation. And in relativistic case, when we speak about synchrotron radiation, by blue we have usual diagram of synchrotron radiation. In the direction of magnetic field, we have nothing without Aronoff-Bohm solenoid. And if you have Aronoff-Bohm solenoid, there appear radiation in this direction. And also what is important, appear super low frequencies, harmonics, with the same values. And also polarization of these harmonics is opposite to other harmonics polarization. Of course, this also open maybe opens experimental possibilities. Now, I don't know how many time.
Well, another 3 minutes and 2 minutes.
Okay. So, and here one can see summary of this result. The presence of the solenoid splits energy levels in the magnetic field and lifts the degeneracy with respect to L in radiation. This splitting provides new spectral lines. All the peculiarities of the radiation related to Aronoff-Bohm solenoid exist only for non-zero mantissa. And new super low frequencies with specific polarization are irradiated along the magnetic field. So that's all.
Very good. We have time for a few questions. Before the questions, I'd like to thank you. It's very nice to talk about particle physics. But you mentioned something about the possible experimental implications of this computation. And you have only single photon thing, and there are softies. Infrared radiation, very soft. Don't you have a thing that you need to do some contribution of many photons and the blue watch finger? No. When he derived the quantum mechanical synchrotron radiation, he did write two papers on this.
The problem is not one photon radiation. The problem is the frequency of the photon.
Yeah.
Frequencies could be very high.
Of course.
So, for example, if you take synchrotron radiation,
very high
frequencies with one photon radiation.
Did you get all multi-photon things? Did you get, in other words, contribution of all photon states? You have Bremsstrahlung in this problem.
Yes, but your question is what? Calculations were not made for many photon.
No, it's Bremsstrahlung. This is what you observe. You mentioned experimental.
No, of course I am a theoretician and I cannot, guarantee you that this can be measured. But we spoke with people which are doing this experimentally from Moscow University, and they even promised us to discover this effect. Only what I can tell now.
Oh, this is like you're doing Lenin times, you know, 5 years ago. Okay, anyway. You have a question? Yes.
Excuse me, when you consider the Iran case,
yes.
You pose the condition that the wave function does not vanish at bound,
yes.
At the origin, which means that it sees. So how can you tell that the question is that the modification of the original cyclotron or synchrotron radiation, which takes place when you put the solenoid, is it a result of this non-local interaction, which is the harmonic bomb, or just it is just because the particle touches the magnetic field?
No, this effect exists without any solenoid. This effect was known before us because
No, without magnetic field. Even without magnetic field, if you study Dirac equation with Aronoff-Bohm solenoid, you will see that with the wave function on zero level with specific L0 is infinite on the solenoid, but still square integrable.
Yes.
It enters in the complete set of functions. And Hagen, for example, who first spoke about this, he studied this, and there are many, for this L, there are many self-adjoint extensions with the same behavior. This is normal. Only this is bad for interpretation of Aronoff-Bohm effect. This way, I don't know, bad or not bad, because there are different ways to interpret Aronoff-Bohm effect. Some people like electron wave function of electron vanishes. For me, it is not necessary to.
For scalar vanishes, for
Schrödinger vanishes, but for Dirac, in one state doesn't vanish.
Fermi of spin 1/2 is very special. This is what he's saying. It has nothing to do with volatility. It's just Landau levels, and he expanded actually in this talk. What happens to the spectrum? It's a problem of the Landau levels.
No, this, in general, these are not Landau levels, because Landau levels are only for non-relativistic case. These are exact levels of Dirac equation, which are not equidistant.
The Landau problem is relativistic. It's Landau problem. Okay.
Landau didn't like Dirac equation.
I think that I was actually advised by the chairman that exactly right 1 hour now. So if you have any questions, please talk to the speaker. You know, you are interested in the field like self-adjoint extensions and so on. You will tell you, because this is you know, von Neumann theory. But physicists, we do finite size, little cylinder, do the matrix, and see what is the limit. And this picks up parameter. Actually, it is in the original paper of Yakir, in the book. To choose the boundary conditions of the wave function, we have to do a little cylinder, very small size, and see what happens in the limit. This is how you select one particular parameter in the von Neumann.
But not every self-adjoint extension can be obtained by this regularization.
Physics is how I get
the finite.